Wave theory and photoelectric effect. Dear students, in 1887, H. Hertz performed an interesting experiment. He made the arrangement as shown in figure. The metal is connected to negative terminal of battery and detector is connected to positive terminal of battery. When a light beam of sufficient energy is allowed to strike over the metal connected to negative terminal, then it is observed that electrons are emitted from metal and travel towards the detector. Accordingly, the current flow is observed by deflection in the emitter. The phenomenon of emission of electrons from metal surface when exposed to beam of light is called photoelectric effect. The electrons emitted due to this effect are called photoelectrons. Observations of photoelectric effect are: if the frequency of incident light beam is below a certain minimum frequency called threshold frequency nu zero, then photoelectric effect will not occur. Thus, the necessary condition for photoelectric effect is incident frequency should be greater than threshold frequency. With the increase in frequency beyond threshold frequency of the incident light, photoelectric effect occurs. Higher the frequency of light beam, greater will be the speed of electrons, and so higher will be their kinetic energy. So, with increase in frequency, current increases. The number of electrons ejected from the metal depends on intensity or brightness of the light beam falling on it. Explanation of photoelectric effect by wave theory. According to wave theory, the number of ejected electrons and their kinetic energy depends on brightness of the light. However, this assumption is incorrect. Number of electrons ejected does not depend on brightness. For example, even if red light of very high brightness is allowed to strike on potassium metal, still no photoelectrons are ejected. However, the same potassium metal, if exposed to yellow light of very small brightness, photoelectrons are ejected. Thus, wave theory fails to explain this phenomena. The more accurate explanation was given by Planck's quantum theory. We will learn this topic in next video.